Good morning. I finished my makeup just now, and I was debating whether or not I should share it with you today. But do you guys see, like, there's like nothing on here? All matte shadows, really nothing lip. So hair needs to be done. This is from yesterday, but I really didn't like my hair. I always like, don't you guys love second day hair so much better? It always looks better. Full on fleece outfit right now. We have a fleece robe, we have fleece pants, and we have fleece booties. And apparently, I've noticed whenever I do my laundry, I essentially buy all animal print. I don't know why. I did so much laundry yesterday. This weekend, I have like no plans, like nothing. It was so awesome. I got home from work yesterday, uploaded the vlog for today, and I was just like, what can I do? I don't really need to do groceries, but I might go pick up some random things. And I did laundry last night, like three loads, two clothes. I did some sheets. Like, it was just like, I don't really know what to do, but I like looked for things to do. I don't know. It's like, this is a really relaxing weekend, I'm hoping.
So I'm gonna have a little bit of food, ooh, before I go. These are the sweet potato noodles with a peanut sauce, peanut butter, which I'm gonna buy this weekend. It's like the best peanut butter ever. And then sweet chili garlic sauce with a little bit of soy sauce and some egg. So good. I kind of want to have this like on hand like all week just so I can have it when I'm hungry. Also, do you remember this brand of salted duck eggs I showed you guys maybe a couple weeks ago? They're so good. I know that looks gross, but they never look cool when you open them. But this is how they should taste, and this is how I would prefer them to be. They're so good. Okay, had food. Okay, I didn't bring my YSL with me to touch up, but I have some in my purse. Okay, now, drama. I also put like a ton of the Oribe dry texturizing spray in my hair because it felt a little flat when I caught myself in the mirror, and now it's like really big, but whatever. It'll die down by the time I like need to get out of the car. It smells so good. Okay. Here's this dramatic situation I must share with you. So I'm working through my YSL Volupt Sheer Candies. I have number 13, I think. 13 and 14. And I think they're getting discontinued. And I had to text Andrew very dramatically because this is like, I think, the first lip product, or not first lip, first makeup item like we truly like really bonded over. Like, this is our thing. I even remember like the first time we met, like when we hung out that weekend for Gen Beauty, like a couple years ago. We had brunch or lunch or breakfast, and we both like pulled these. Oh my god, like I remember these moments. So I was like, I can't find these. I can't find them on Sephora. I can't find them on Nordstrom. I can't find them on Selfridges. The only place I found them was on Lord & Taylor, and there was only like five shades. And it's on the YSL US website still, but I really think they're getting discontinued. And then Beauty Lookbook. So if you guys don't follow her, you should. She did a blog post on the new ones with the little lips in them, and she said that the other ones are going away. These sheer candies are going away. Like, I love these. Like, the colors for the other ones are like okay. They're like not super my thing. I don't know. I'm like sad. I feel like I have no makeup on today. Isn't that weird? I mean, I have makeup on, but I feel like I don't have any makeup on. I also feel like my hair is like too big for its own good right now. Okay, mess number one, Marshalls. I found this little thing. How pretty, $1.99. What am I putting in this? I don't know yet, but so pretty. I got two dog toys for Echo. Okay, first of all, this one's so cute, right? It's a dinosaur. I have like this thing for dinosaurs because when I was young, or anyone who's like around my age, The Land Before Time, like that was like one of the best movies, like so sad. And like Bambi, oh my god. Okay, anyway, so little toy for Echo. This one's kind of small, and there was another one that was a Tyrannosaurus, but like he wasn't as cute. But then I kept going and I found a flying dragon. How cute, right? Are we like adorableness? And then I picked up a Maybelline Baby Lips sunscreen. I actually really love baby lips. I have the Maybelline, the medicated one, and that's gonna be in an empties. I have never shown it to you guys because I basically keep it in the office and I use it during the day, and I've just never mentioned it. But this one has SPF. peppermint, all good things that I like. Okay, so then I went to Mark's. Mark's is like a local place that is similar pricing to Target and or Walmart, sometimes cheaper. We've got chia seeds. These were $2.50. I don't know if that's a good price or not. I haven't really bought chia seeds before, but 12 ounces. And Chobani Greek yogurt. If any of you guys have a lot of experience with Greek yogurt, let me know what brands to buy. I really like the website Eat This Not That. But this is what they had. They had this and they had like Danone something and Oikos sometimes. I don't know. So I got this. We'll try to be healthy, you know. You know those girls on Instagram or like YouTube who are like all fancy with their acai bowls and they wear like workout clothes as real clothes and their hair is like undone and perfect and oh, I hate them. Why? Wait, I have never seen these girls in real life. And by I hate them, I mean I wish I could be like, you know, so chic and effortless. Okay, so Dove. Okay, I love me some dry shampoo. I really love the Elizabeth and James white, Nirvana white. I haven't tried the black yet, maybe I will. But that's $28 a can. I really like that one. And you know, whatever ones I get sent, I try out a lot. But I wanted to find something that's like good at the drugstore. Whenever I look for the Pantene one, I can never find it. After Tati did that video, like the best drugstore, or like the best dry shampoo, I think Pantene won, and I never ever see it whenever I look. But I was sniffing this one and I've seen reviews for this. The reviews are always really good. This smells so good. I cannot wait to use it. It's like fresh, kind of floral, really feminine. Oh my God, am I like, this is not a tampon. This is a dry shampoo, but it smells so good. And this was like $3.92, I think. This is the best peanut butter ever. I asked the internet what the best peanut butter was and they told me this is like one of those, comes up in the list a lot. It is so good. I already went through a jar the last time I had one, and I guess you get separation, which is normal, but so good. I showed these to you. I bought these before. They're the strawberry crepes, and they're only at this one Mark's that's like further away from me. These are so good. So good. And I think I shared with you before, there's like no preservatives, no artificial flavoring, no artificial coloring. So not that they're healthy, but like there's no bad stuff.
Okay, good morning. Okay, hair is not done. Makeup, almost mostly done, and clearly we are not changed. Okay, so I had some packages come in yesterday, and I wanted to share them with you because I want your opinion. So, last vlog or two vlogs ago, I showed you guys a Henri Bendel clutch, the A-List Petrol clutch, and there was like a weird spot on it. Like it's that beautiful kind of, here, it looks like this. This is the card holder I have in that same kind of leather. And I love the card holder because I love this so much. I picked this up in January in LA when I was with Andrew and we both got something at Henri Bendel. I got the clutch and I showed it to you guys. There was like a weird random spot that like wasn't smooth. Like when you would move it, there'd be like a really weird spot. So I was debating whether to return it. Some of you guys said yes, some of you guys said no. I returned it because I knew that because when something's off, I knew that I just wouldn't reach for it because I would be so paranoid about that part of it. So I returned that. That is on the way. So here's the thing with this print. The print, it's called Petrol, but not every single product that is like this is labeled that way. And I've noticed that sometimes there's like 7 products that are done in this leather and other times will be like 2. So I think either it sells out quickly or the stock isn't like constant. So I saw this wallet and I thought it was actually going to be smaller. I think it's called the Turnlock. No, maybe I'm making that up. Keyhole? Stop trying. So I got it and the size is great because I actually thought it was going to be like slightly bigger than this, like maybe like another third of this, but it's actually much bigger, which I really love. And it has a zipper in the back, but look at this. Do you see how this is like so beautiful and oil slicky? And this is just like what happened. Like that's the front. It's also slightly crooked. And then that's the back. The back is slightly better, but the inside is absolutely stunning. Like, what happened? Why couldn't the outside be like the inside? I mean, look how gorgeous that is. Also, I think whatever it is that they do to make the leather look like that, they put like way too much on in the front because like I said, it's so like black and this is like actually very much more mottled. Like there's much more texture on the inside And then on the outside, it's like almost, it's so much smoother. So I feel like such a bitch, but I'm gonna return this. I mean, however, there is another one of these wallets. It's in green. Like the leather is green and then this thing is gold and it's so pretty. But I need to like have the price go down. Like I need these to be like under 100 for me to like consider picking them up. I think this was like 94. So sad. Anyway, okay, so the next thing I picked up is this purse. Isn't this gorgeous? I need you guys to help me decide whether I should keep it. How beautiful. It's this like copper, I guess like metallic copper on the front. This is a magnetic closure. And in here, just get rid of that and the dust bag. So there is a zipper pocket here, and then like a big pocket here, and then there's like a place for your cards. And then on this side, you have zippers. So you can undo the zippers and you have like this effect, so you can like open it up much bigger, which I think is so cool. See that? Okay, so this is what got me. This is the front, right? Or I guess that's not the front. Either side can be the front. This is the other side. How beautiful. Like the sun's making it much like redder. I mean, even I look super pale right now because the sun is out. It's 70 degrees today, guys. So excited. This is the other side. And then there's like a turn lock. So you open it up that way. And then you have one pocket here and then another. This whole other big thing is just like a big open compartment. So gorgeous. I think the dimensions are like 10 inches by 8 inches, which is like, it's like borderline okay sizing. Like I don't go more than 10 inches in general for purses because they look big on me. So, let me see. The original price of this was $565. Oh, the brand is, I don't know how to pronounce this. Etienne Einer? Is that how you pronounce it? Anyway, I see her stuff often. Gosh, is it a boy or girl? I don't know why. I don't know the sex of that name. $565 is the original price and the style is 900153. I got it off TJ Maxx for $149.99. Would you keep this? I think it's so cute. It has a crossbody. That's like again the front and then the back. Now you're like, wow, it's like $150. Why are you even thinking about it? I don't know, right? It's kind of weird. Like I'm into all these like bougie high-end purses, but like this thing's $150 and I'm like, I don't know, should I keep it? I'm gonna tell you why. So this front part that is so stunning, this leather, each piece is kind of like almost like individually placed. So let me get really up close. So do you see this? Like these are all individually kind of on there. So some of them are starting to lift, and the ones that aren't lifted, I'm sure eventually with time might lift. I mean, right now it looks beautiful. Is there a way to not make it lift? Is there a reason? Is this like a look? Like, I know this is a look, just like cap hair is a look, which I think is so disgusting, but I love this purse. I think it's so beautiful. It's such a great like fall piece. Like obviously I could keep this and just, you know, save it for fall, but it's so beautiful. But this one part, even though it's just like $150, I'm like, is this a main concern for me? I think it kind of is because I'm thinking about it, right? Let me know. I'll link it below or try to find it, because sometimes things on TJ Maxx, I feel like they get like two of something, but I'll try and find it if I can wherever, and I'll link it below for you guys if you're interested, but please input on this, very much needed. Okay, so one thing I have been meaning to, okay, I released my hair from the, from its harness. I don't know if that was a good idea, but I put earrings in to distract. I also am wearing these sunglasses today to distract. They're by Key. I showed them to you maybe like sometime late last year. They're so cute, right? They're so gold and they're probably not gonna be like lasting that long, but they're like so bomb. Like how cool, how much more bomb and gold can I look right now? I love these, so cute. Okay, anyway. Okay, so one thing I've been meaning to share with you guys, and I always remember after I like edit my vlogs, actually my hair looks not that bad. I didn't want to curl it more because I'm like, if it doesn't need to be curled, I don't want to damage it with more curling. But also, do you hear that in background noise? Let me get into that later. I notice when I edit my vlogs, I forgot to tell you this. So
This is the YSL baby Kabas bag that I love carrying. It's like so cute, but it has a really thin crossbody strap. And because of that, it's always twisting, always turning. It's not very comfortable. So I was like, oh, I wonder what strap I can find. So I was always like slowly on the lookout for like an alternative strap. And I found this one at TJ Maxx. I think it was like $8 or $10. It's faux leather, obviously, but the gold on it actually matches the gold hardware on here. So I thought it was like a pretty good thing. I think you can't even tell. It just looks like it's a really like different looking YSL bag, which I love. It makes this bag so much easier to carry. I know this is like such a faux pas. It's like faux leather. It's like this huge guitar strap, but you know what? Whatever. It totally works for me and it works for my vibe. Okay. So, oh my God, pants are falling off. Okay. So is she wearing the same shirt she wore yesterday? Yeah. Cause she only wore it for like 2 hours. I very much wanted to share my makeup with you today because I got some really awesome PR in from Pure and it is so pretty. It's their filter primer and their this like bronzer thing. But because it's so beautiful out today and it's like sunny weather, all the men in this neighborhood have decided to either power wash their like driveways, you guys hear that, or mow their lawns. And I seriously was so pissed because most of that activity was taking place on the side of my house where I usually show you guys my makeup, and I'm so mad. I wanted to show you guys everything so badly, and I kept waiting for it to stop, but I'm like, it's only gonna get warmer, it's only gonna get brighter, and people are only going to emerge to do more outdoor things to their home. Oh my God, the hair actually doesn't, it's so weird how like things look better on camera sometimes and sometimes things look way worse on camera. I'm loving these sunglasses, obsessed. I have such an easy day today. I need to go to the bank and get some cash, and then I need to get something from Target that I'm so excited about.
Okay, so went to Target, gloves, that doesn't matter, this stuff. Actually really cheap there, $1.99. These are, okay, first of all, Ghirardelli makes the best mixes and Andrew thinks so too. So I'm like, was watching a vlog, I'm like, oh my God, and he was talking about it. I'm like, I think this too. So I've shown this to you guys in a vlog before, and I did like, did I do something where I put marshmallow on it? But anyway, first of all, I only do dark chocolate. Inside the Ghirardelli mixes, they have these huge chocolate chips that are amazing. And I want to take the Vietnamese coffee caramels that I had picked up from Trader Joe's and throw them in here because I think it'll be so good. This is the reason why I went to Target. Andrew had done a mukbang with this and he had banh mi and fries, and I was just like, it looks so good. But mostly I had seen this at Target so many times, I just like never got it because I'm like, oh, well, I don't know if I'm gonna like it or not, and I don't wanna like get it and not like it. And then in his most recent vlog, this was just like making random appearances constantly. So I was like, I need to get this. This was 30% off, which makes it a really good price because I'm always just refilling the containers I have. Archer Farms coconut basmati rice. Basmati? How do you say this? I don't know. It looked good. It has really great reviews. I'm going to try it. Then I went to Aldi and I got potato puffs, tater tots, and these crinkle cut fries because I'm gonna have that mayo later.
Okay, so after mad complaining about other people doing shit outside, it is so nice out. Like, I think I'm going to clean the inside of my car, and by that I mean vacuum. So now I'm gonna be the loud person in their driveway doing shit. But this weather, oh, I'm so happy. Like, it's so good. Like, it's so magnificent.
Okay, so perfect timing that I got these gloves today because I was cleaning and I wanted to share these with you. These are the Armor All air freshening protectant wipes for your like the interior of your car. These are in Cool Mist. These smell so amazing. Every time I clean my car, it just smells so good. Oh, it's like fresh, clean, but also kind of like, you know, man scent. Ugh, so, so yummy. Like, not yummy, but like, it's like sexy and clean. Like, I don't know. That. And I figured while we were here, I would show you like what I keep in the console.
Okay, so I have this little thing here that you pop open, and I have gum in here. I just keep refilling this container pretty much. And then in here, I have one of the Henry Bendel candles that I love. So I keep it in the car, so it like keeps the car smelling good. This is not gonna focus. Yeah, the Sweet 712, but I keep it in one of these like, what do you call these? Like these faux chiffon bags, so like the candle itself doesn't get dusty, but the scent still comes out. I hope this is not wobbly. And then this is like the main console. And, ooh, flying things. Okay, so there's just napkins here. Whenever I get fast food and I need napkins, or have leftover, I put them in there. And these are things, I don't know, I think those are parts of the car. I have quarters there for when I go to Aldi, some hair things. And then deep down in this console, we have tire gauge, my deodorant that I love so much. I have just a few plastic bags, tissue paper. This is Laura Mercier Amber Vanilla. This smells so similar to that Bum Bum cream from Sol de Janeiro. I have a Shea Body Mist from Body Shop. This is like an easy, clean, fun scent. This is from Misha. It's a ginger vinegar spray that you can put on your feet, like if they're smelling bad. So I just keep it in here randomly if I ever have to take my shoes off and change shoes. These shoe sponges are like the best things ever for when you're like, any kind of leather is dirty, or even faux leather, doesn't even matter. Toilet paper, lighter, a pen, scissors. Okay, so from this console, we go to the back seat, and I have this drawer back here, and I just keep like bottled water. I only have one right now, but that's just what we keep back there.
Okay, fries. This sauce thing is like way too big. I need to get a smaller one. Totally gonna look for one the next time I'm out. Like a cute, like, I don't know, maybe like a cute shape or like a gold one. Anyway, so we got fries. We have the sriracha mayo, and then we have coconut water. And oh, Hello Kitty. Every time I like rearrange this coffee table, which is really not that often, I always keep it. If it's not here, it's on like, the other side of the table. And like, oh, okay. There's also body lotion. Oh my God. Okay. So, okay. Weird non-filtered moment. Whenever I see lotion, I sit there and I think someone's masturbating. Is that weird? Not someone, obviously a guy, but like, oh, why is that my reference? You know what? I just watched 13 Reasons Why and there was like a scene. Maybe that's why. I like literally saw the lotion. And I like mildly freaked out and I was like, why am I freaking out? It's just body lotion and I'm not a boy. So anyway, I'm going to eat these fries.
We have some oil, avocado oil heating up in a pan. 5 eggs. This dried seaweed. It's very simple. There's like no flavor to it. It is, there's like no salt even. Okay, so a little bit of the egg. And then maybe half of the seaweed. And then the rest of the egg. So then you have something like this. The other side has like way more egg, and I'm probably gonna put black pepper on this.
Okay, so earlier that like omelet seaweed thing, I'm just gonna cut it into like a lot of pieces.
So I put a whole bunch into this container, and then this is like the leftover for later. So what's gonna happen is I'm just gonna take this to work, and I'm gonna take the miso ginger broth from Trader Joe's also to work. So for lunch, I'll just like pour this in and heat it up and I'll have like a little soup. This recipe is from like, where did I get this? I don't know, I think I just wanted egg with seaweed, but not like separately the way you typically see like a miso soup or an egg drop soup. Maybe this is a combination of the two, but my grandpa used to do this with like glass noodles, the clear glass noodles, and then he'd put it into like an omelet type thing and then have it in soup. So it's just kind of a take on that, and it's fairly healthy, so kind of excited.
Good morning, it's Monday morning, and like I said, I wanted to share my makeup with you yesterday, but I couldn't because loud. So it's super quiet this morning outside of maybe like garbage trucks. So I feel like I have a lot of products to talk about, so hopefully this doesn't take too long. So I had shared with you TJ Maxx purchased, Henry Bendel purchased, the same day that those came in, this box came in the mail. Also, and I was like, oh my God, what did I buy? No, it was some PR from Pure. And there's two products that I have both on today that I am obsessed with. And I wore them yesterday, so now I can give you like a full on more review. More review? Yeah. So one is a bronzer, one's a film, like photography primer thing, and then the other's a bronzer. They also sent this shirt that says no filter, which is pretty cute. I mean, I'm into it. It's a medium. I'll probably like cut the neckline a little because I don't like that. And the packaging's really cute. Like the box was cool and then like it's like so adorable, right? Sometimes people do really great job with their PR. Sometimes you just get like this like unidentifiable box with like, you never really know. So for skincare, we have the Clarins Super Restorative Total Eye Concentrate, love. And then I use the Clinique Dramatically Different Moisturizing Gel. I usually use the lotion, but I got this, I don't know, maybe they sent this a couple weeks ago with a whole bunch of other skincare that are like minis, so which is great for travel, but I love this. Okay, so the first thing I have on is the Pure No Filter Blurring Photography Primer. It's in this like dropper, and you really have to shake it up. I would say, don't use it if you don't shake it up. So when I first saw photography primer, it reminded me of two other items that I have. One is by Niode and one is by Hylamide. Both are by the company Deciem. And this is the Photography Fluid Opacity 12%. And then this is the Hylamide Photography Foundation. This has two shades. So let me explain to you the premise behind these and why I had purchased these. These were like really big on like UK beauty blogs. So of course I became intrigued. They're primers that look white and they have a very warm yellowy kind of gold filter once applied to your skin. So there's those three. They're all very white. So when you blend them out, that's the Niode. That one is quite opaque and yellow. This is the Hylamide, a little more sheer, and then this is the Pure. You can see that the, excuse me, the Pure one is much more, I guess, smooth and it blends out a little easier. These, I think, depending on your skin tone, especially the Niode, this one is very, very warm and it leaves a very, really beautiful golden filter on your skin. And then the Hylamide also does a pretty good job of that. And then this is the Pure one. You can see it's like much lighter and it blends in much easier. These are like thicker formulas. They're all gorgeous. Like you see, your skin is going to look beautiful underneath. But when I do use the other two, especially say the Niode, I do have to kind of make sure I don't look too yellow because it can definitely do that. And then the Hylamide one does a really good job too, and they also have one in golden tan that you kind of use as a bronzer. Essentially, I really love this Pure one. You saw the way they blend it out. This is so pretty. It leaves your skin looking very luminous and very even, which I really like. And you guys know I'm not big on primers. I feel like my over decade plus of wearing makeup, I haven't been into primers until like the past couple years. And only in the last 6 months have I been finding primers that I really, really love. And I think part of it is definitely primers are so much better now. They used to be very just pore filling and they didn't really do much outside of filling your pores and blurring your skin. And I always felt like whenever you'd put stuff on top of it, it would just look thick and like you weren't really getting any of your foundation on the skin anymore. It was just sitting on top of the primer, which didn't look good. It didn't look blended. But I feel like in the past, like maybe 3 years, a lot of primers are so good. So I've got this. One pump of the La Mer in linen. We have the Amazing Concealer Hydrate in medium beige under the eyes. I feel like I should have put more, like another concealer on top of this because I tend to use this as a concealer and corrector on like easy days like today. And then usually I guess I would put another concealer on top of it. Set the face with the Ulta Banana Powder. Okay, so this is the other product that Pure sent over. It's called the Bronze Your Selfie Skin Perfecting Face and Body Liquid Bronzer. So whenever I see liquid bronzers, I always want to use them as like a contour. I want to use them kind of all over the skin, but they're kind of more, I feel like this is not like a beginner's makeup person's thing because you need to know which brush to use. You need to kind of play with it to determine how much the amount that is appropriate for you. And you also need to determine if you're using it as a layering step or if you're just gonna use it as your bronzer. And that also depends on the formula, whether it's gonna slip or slide. So when I first saw this, I was like, oh my God, so excited. It has really beautiful packaging. I'm like so into this packaging. So this is the color, looks very orange, but it's like actually a very beautiful brown with like gold shimmer in it. So there's it blended out. Do you see? I can't wait to wear this on my body. Like for now, I have it on my skin. And I had worn it for you guys yesterday, but I don't know if you could really see, but today I have it on the skin. Do you see how I don't really look like I have bronzer on? Do you know what I mean? Like my skin is just really glowing. The La Mer foundation is a satin matte. So, I mean, look at this. And it looked like this the whole day. I kept catching myself in the mirror like, wow, everything looks so even and beautiful and the bronzer doesn't look like bronzer. It just looks like my skin is kind of like really healthy. So like I said, using something like this, usually you would like squeeze it onto the back of your hand or you squeeze it onto a palette. But I feel like it's still difficult to use and get an even amount and then have it blended out properly is also difficult because it's a liquid, and when you put it like a, just a goop anywhere and you just go like this with your brush, it's not gonna look cute. So my trick for this, and I've done this with my Giorgio Armani Liquid Summer, I put it into a cushion. So I took the sponge out, this was like a clean one, and I squirted a whole bunch of the bronzer into it, and then I put the sponge back in and I squeezed more on top of it. So basically what I do is I put my brush into there. This is a Zoeva Face Shape, and I use this pretty much for all of my bronzers, not bronzers, liquid bronzers. So this is what one layer looks like. Still really pretty. This is what two layers looks like. That's what I did on my skin. And then there's three layers. So it's very, very buildable. It's a very thin formula. It's very buildable. I love it so much. I think even if you're really fair and you're like, I don't know if I can even go into like liquid bronzer territory, you can with this. I mean, as you look, like that's not... And that's just like me pressing it in. Like when you blend it out, it becomes even lighter. And I'm like at level two here. This is like level three. You can just keep building it and it looks really good. I think it also dries kind of quick. So like kind of once you blend it in, definitely kind of decide where you want it. Don't like be just being, it's not like powder where you can just kind of like buff it away. You kind of need to work with it fairly quickly, but not so quick that it's gonna like look muddy. You know what I mean? It's like kind of perfect in that way. And then for the nose, I just used the Zoeva Concealer Buffer in 142 and I ran it down my nose very, very subtly. Like it's not very obvious, and in this lighting, definitely you can't see it. I keep fussing with my hair. I wanted to share this with you. It's perfect that I have this because I wanted to update you guys on this. I feel like I need like I washed my hair last night, so today, this morning, it doesn't have very much zhuzh. So let me get this in here. This dry shampoo works really well. I've been using it since I got it. Okay, now, I've determined that it has like a berry floral scent, kind of. It kind of reminds me of like Bath & Body Works scents, which, you know, they're like so pedestrian, right? But it's fine. It's not gonna be bougie. It's like, you know, it's drugstore, but the product works really well. I might rebuy it if I can try other scents out because I don't like things that have like a berry scent to it. Because initially I was like, oh, it's kind of fresh, it's kind of floral. But once I actually like really used it, like for a couple days, I found that I think that it's much more, it just smells like Bath & Body Works to me. Anyway, okay, so for the eyes, we just prepped with the Tony Moly Panda's Dream Eye Brightening Eye Base all over the eyes, up into the brow. And then I used this Shiseido Shimmering Cream Eye Color in BR306. I really like this. It's very, very pretty. Looks like that. And then pulled out the Catrice Liquid Metal Eyeshadow in Nougat It Right. This is like my color. Like, I live for colors like this. These kind of like reddish browns with a little bit of metallic into it. Like the one Milani palette, is it something Earth? Am I making that up? It has like a really gorgeous color like that in there. And then Makeup Geek has a color, steampunk maybe? Or am I making that up? That I really love. Then we have the liquid pencil from Lancome in the black shade. And we have Tom Ford Deeper, which I'm not gonna swatch. And then I have this MAC Peter and Harry? Paragon. Anyway, it's the Crayon Kohl in Paragon. And I have this on the lower waterline. I don't really do that often. That used to be like Andrew's thing, like back in the day. But so here's a little swatch. This is the Shiseido, this is the Catrice, the Lancome in the tight line, and then the Paragon in the waterline. So that's kind of like a closer up look. I really should have worn more concealer today. I did not sleep all night. I probably woke up to pee like 8 times. I don't even know why. I think because, I don't know if I was like nervous for today, like I'm going to the dentist and I'm getting a tooth pulled, which I don't know why would make me nervous, but like I could not sleep at all. And I feel like it is definitely showing, and I probably, actually I'm gonna put more concealer on. Rather, actually, like we'll do like an eye brightener because I already like powdered the under eye, but I always use a damp beauty blender, so we'll see if it doesn't look too bad. Oh, I love that so much more than what I had before. This looks so much better, so much brighter. Do we like that? I love it. Okay. Oh my God, so much better. Is it too white now? Maybe it'll calm down in a little bit. Okay, so what I used was the Stroke of Light from Bare Minerals. It's an eye brightener and it's in the shade Luminous 2. Did I just ruin my eye makeup? I can't tell, guys. I did not use a mirror. I literally just stood in front of here. Okay, anyway, I guess we can't really do anything about that if it looks really bad. All right, so that's the eye makeup. For the brows, okay, this is gonna be our official review on the Black Up Matte Waterproof Brow Powder Gel and Brush. You've seen this in, I wanna say, the past 2 or 3 vlogs for sure, because I've been using it and testing it out. Now, you have a brush on one end. It's not the thinnest brush, but it is one of those brushes that's really kind of, it's like denser, so when you are using kind of like a creamier product, it helps pull it through the brows really easily. I think it's more better. I think it's preferable if you have like thicker brows. On the other end, you have your product. This product inside here is amazing. Whenever I use it, I feel like my brows, not I feel like, I know that my brows stay on all day. The whatever shape I have created for them with this, it stays the whole day, and that to me is so important. Especially wherever I have gaps, especially the tail, especially at the front of the brows to draw in like those fake hairs, it's so good. Would I recommend this product to you? Absolutely. I absolutely think it's worth it if you have sparse to medium brows. If you have really thick brows, it's not necessary unless you happen to have fairly like large gaps that you really need to ensure that they maintain their non-gapness throughout the day. So in the beginning, I did use the brush here, but then over time I realized I should just go back to brushes that I'm used to, and this is the Japanese 211. It's shaped like this. I'm pretty sure it's like an eyeshadow brush, but it's just small enough and just sparse enough. Like, it's not super dense. And also, because this thing is so super tiny, it really allows me to get in there and sweep the product through my brows really properly, or at least the way I like them. So I absolutely love this product and absolutely recommend it because it doesn't budge. It is matte, it is waterproof. If the colors of this brand are like black, white, and red, I would have preferred the inside of this be like white or red, or another color so that you can actually see the product in here, or maybe put the product in here on this end because it's larger so you can actually see the product more. And I think it would have been great to have had a spoolie somewhere. I mean, I don't know where, you could have put the spoolie, but I mean, because I don't use this brush, I guess I wish it would have been a spoolie, but then how would you get the product? Obviously the delivery system leaves a little bit to be desired, but I love the product in here. It's super lightweight. It's very travel friendly. I have liked, and this is made in Korea. Yay. I have liked everything that I've tried from Black Up. I mean, obviously it is made for, geared towards women of color. So there's a lot of like base products I can't use, i.e. like foundations and concealers, but like their contouring compact, really beautiful. Andrew has used the highlighter in the lightest shade. The formula of that highlighter is amazing. It's just like, for me, it'd be way too warm and way too yellow and it wouldn't look good on me at all, but maybe it would look really good on the skin though, like in the summer. I don't know. The formula of that was beautiful. Okay, so lastly on the, oh, as I come closer to you, lastly on the lips, it's the Marc Jacobs in Taboo. It's the Enamored High Shine Lip Lacquers, and this one's in Taboo. For me, I love this one because it's very like my lips, but better. Like when I apply this to my lips, I'm like, that is exactly my lip color, but like it smooths out, evens out the whole thing, and I love it so much. For the VIB sale, there is this trio. They have a trio of glosses that are full size, and then they have four kind of more pinky colors that are like a deluxe size. Definitely gonna get the trio. There's French Tickler, which I've been wanting. I know Andrew has it. There's kind of like a purple lilac-y shade, and then like another kind of more mauve-y color. I'm very excited because I love these glosses. These are so good. They go on so smooth. They are a little sticky, so if that's not your thing, but they have high shine, so love. I also feel like, oh, lastly, so for highlight today, I use the primer again because it's so pretty. Maybe I'll put a little more on. So, I mean, you can already see it here. I put like, you know, concealer here, but this is still the primer. Do you guys see this? I'm obsessed. So I always apply the primer with a finger, like that has the primer, and then I blend it out with a clean finger. I know you're like, wow, so technical. Yeah, basically, so apply the primer with one finger and then find a clean finger, wherever that may be, and blend it in. Do you guys see that? Like, it's so beautiful. It's like the most beautiful, like your skin just looks beautiful. Let me drop some down the nose. Ooh, you see? Do you see? So pretty. So that's my favorite part to highlight because it really does bring like the light and straight and narrow thing if that's what you're going for. And then I run it right down there, which shouldn't be super evident. And I always skip the reindeer part. That's not cute. Okay, so that is the makeup essentially today. I feel like I need to like do this. The Smashbox Photo Finish Primer Water. Yes, that looks so much better because I feel like because we had already powdered and we went over with this thing, we couldn't. That's not that cute. Okay, so that is the makeup for today. I hope you guys liked it. One last thing. The Brazilian Bum Bum Cream. I've been talking about this on and off since I got it. I don't think that it's like super moisturizing, but it makes your skin look really, really pretty. And the scent lingers for such a long time. I love it so much. If you like pistachio scented things, Laura Mercier does a scent. I think it's called Amber Vanilla, or it's, and they have one called Pistache de Creme or something. It smells kind of similar to that. This smells lighter. Like I sometimes find the Laura Mercier to be like too, like you do one extra spray and it's just like too much, but this, oh, you will smell this all day long. If you're somebody that also doesn't like to wear like perfume, it smells so good. I don't know, here's the thing. I think if it's, so the Bum Bum Cream, right, and it's supposed to be like firming and lifting. I think if you are like borderline, like, you know, like you work out, you have like decent definition, yeah, it'll feel, because it's not super moisturizing, it has kind of like a slight tightening effect. But if you, you know, you never work out and like you put it on, obviously you're not gonna see any effects. But I agree with Andrew, they need to come out with like a home collection, like candles, reed diffusers. Like I would put this in my house. I would put it in my beach house that I don't have, or I would just put it on like all year long so I can smell it, because it smells so, so good. Also love the packaging. Like The lip butter, so cute. This, so cute. Like, and I love that it's like this round. I don't know why, like when things are have like an ergonomic grip, I just like them so much more, because when things are convenient, you want to use them more, if that makes any sense at all.
So that cheesy cauliflower I made last time, I made it again, but I switched out the regular mayo with the sriracha mayo. So, I mean, basically you have that boiled cauliflower, drain it, throw a little bit of oil into a pan and toss the cauliflower. And then I just add however much mayo slash cottage cheese that I want. And then once that's kind of like melted, then I throw in some shredded cheddar and then toss that, and it gets super melty and yummy. And then black pepper. It's so good. I've never loved cauliflower like this until now. Okay. We're gonna try vlogging from this angle, from further away. I seriously feel like when my camera's like right here and like I'm over here, it's literally filming me from like this angle, and it's just so not cute. So I really wanna try this version and see if it's better. Okay, so I have a dentist appointment today. It's kind of on the other side of town, but the Trader Joe's is there. So I'm gonna go there, and then so the rundown for the tooth is I have to get this tooth down here extracted and then prepped for an implant. Meantime, while we wait for that to kind of settle in, I have to get a root canal up here, and I have to get two crowns up here. Like, seriously, and by the time, I don't know, my bank account's not depleted, I need to then put the implant in. I'm just like, and this tooth, the one I'm getting extracted, I have had issues since I was like a kid. It has had like multiple cavities, like probably the same cavity. I just honestly think the original dentist did like a horrible job. And then I had to get a root canal, and then that root canal had to be fixed by another doctor who is then gonna do this root canal. It's just been a mess. I went to go see this doctor up here, like probably like for like 3 or 4 root canals at some point, like 5-6 years ago. It's so weird. Not weird, it's horrible, and it costs a lot of money. But yeah, let me look. I want to see if like that's not that cute. This eye is okay, you know, where I applied the concealer over the powder. But on this eye is not my favorite eye, because I have like more fine lines on this one, and I don't know why. Okay.